Happy OCG Thursday and Thanksgiving Black Friday sale later Saturday or Friday morning at 6 a.m. EST. As soon as that market watcher drops, the sale goes live. You guys will get the chance to get some really crazy stuff. All right, my gem deck box is gonna go up. You guys are gonna love this thing. All right, it's actually beautiful. So, well, what's going on? What's going on in the OCG world today? So, we actually have a Machina list here. This is actually really cool. So this deck is going to be focusing on the skill drain axis of things, and it's also going to be focusing on creating these big boss monsters. Now, you guys know that Citadel is this new fun fancy card that we just got in the Machina structure deck. We now have a consistency engine now for Machina, which is really nice. So what deck do? Deck stun. Deck stun indeed. So we have triple copies of Astral Blossom and Joyous Spring because we want hand traps in our life. And then we want two copies of Banker Tops, the ability to go second, blow the opponent out. More diversity in your deck building strategy is always a good thing. Then we have two copies of Citadel. So this must be special summoned by a card effect. Quick effect, you can target one machine monster in your graveyard, destroy that target, and, oh yeah, so you target a machine monster, pop it, bada bing, and destroy all monster your opponent controls with that less than or equal to it. And if a face up Earth Machine monster monsters you control, except for Citadel's Destroy by Battle card effect, you get to bring this back out of the graveyard. So you actually make this thing pop itself and resolve in the graveyard underneath skill drain, and then you just continuously punish your opponent. Seems good to me. Then we have two copies of Old Fortress. Summoning conditions, discard some number of monsters totaling 8 or more that are machine. You had to bring this on out. This also will speed up the Citadel process for us. Basically, you can discard the Citadel for the Fortress, and then when this dies, you get to bring this out. Cute little interactions for 500. We have triple copies of Gearframe, but of course. Then we have one copy of the Unclassed Spare. So if this card is added to your hand, except by drawing it, you get to special summon this card from your hand. You cannot special summon for the rest of this turn except for machine monsters. If this card is no more special summon, you can send a machine monster from your deck to the graveyard, except for Unclassed Spare. So we get the ability to drop our big guy here. If we add this from our deck to our hand, we get the ability to summon it, which will basically be granted us the extender to play. And then, of course, we have two Scrap Recycler, because teehee, whichever combo piece we need. We have one limit removal, triple copies of this fun little fantastic card. This gives us the ability to kind of capitalize on searching whatever piece that we need. Do not underestimate the ability to search for combo pieces in two forms. I think that's probably the best thing that we've got going for us here, is that ability to go, hey, want to watch me search my combo pieces? It's actually really, really nice. Outside of that, yeah. Next up, we have X-Stravs. We have the Back to the Front. Then we have two copies of Punishment. Imperial Iron Wall, I found this was a little bit weird, but depending on the metagame, this is good. One in pre-order, two copies of the Machina Overdrive, triple copies of Skill Drain with triple Solemn Judgment, two Torrential, and one Emptiness. Extra deck, one Wyvern, one Clefort Genius, one Anger Knuckle. I always loved seeing this card. One Juggernaut, one Gustav Max, one Galaxy Destroyer, one Ultimate Falcon. And then we have Mr. Super Train Dora the Explorer, two copies of Gigant, two copies of Double A Zeus, one copy of Mr. Last Warrior, one copy of Skull Knight, and one copy of Venintis. Side deck here, we have two Lancia, two Nibiru, triple copies of Gamma, one Driver, one Feather Duster with two copies of Virgin Schedule, two Dimensional Barrier, and two copies of Waking the Dragon, wrapping up a fun little Machina experience for everybody. Like I said, little cute toolbox things like this have potential. I think that there are ideas and things that we can explore from things like this. Just how consistent the end results will be really depends on how it's going. Next up, we have Spiral. Now, here in the TCG, we don't have Master Plan. This makes me cry every time. So this basically is a showcase to show how Spirals have continued to evolve in the OCG. I also see here that we are playing the Pot of Disparity now. Your consistency has been risen, ladies and gentlemen. You'll get to combo off on the full spectrum of things that we've continued on. And now you, this is cool. I really like this. So we have triple copies of Astral Blossom and Joyous Spring, triple copies of Magician Souls, because dropping the Master Plan is the best thing that we've got in this deck, two copies of Maxi, one Drone with one Last Resort, two copies of Master Plan with one Quick Fix, one Sleeper, and two copies of Super Agent. And then we have two Called by the Grave. I wish we had two Called by the Grave. Two copies of Crossout, or Triple Crossout Designator, two copies of Droplet, one Monster Reborn, one 1-for-1, triple copies of Pot of Disparity with one Big Red, two copies of Resort. Man, OCG, you guys are crazy. You have two of those? I wish we could get two of those. We don't even get good cards here. We have one Terraforming to search for our good card. And then we have triple copies of Where Are Thou. Then we have one Imperm, one Utility Wire, and triple copies of Rescue. Down here in the extra deck, we have one Tribe Gate. This is the only deck that can still do the U-Link on the opponent. And it is very interesting. Two copies of Double Helix, one copy of Selene, one Security Dragon, one Secure Gardener, one Relinquished Anima, one Lilink Karibo, one Unicorn, one Phoenix, one Cerberus, one Barricade Borg Blocker, one Apollosa, one Access Code, and one Princess Sprite. Side deck here, we have an Alpha, two Lancia, two Gamma Seal, two Nibiru, one Feather Duster, triple copies of Lightning Storm, two copies of Mind Control, and two copies of Red Rebuto. Wrapping up Spiral. Now, like I said, I know we don't have the whole stupid Master Plan here. I wish we did. But I think it is really cool to see how Pot of Disparity, once again, in a deck like this, the OCG has not played this deck in forever. And they've got all these cards. This is the big difference between the TCG and the OCG. They have Engage at multiples. They have Master Plan here at higher numbers, but they are not taking advantage of this and playing it in crazy moralistic values like this. Like, can this card come back? I don't know, but it's interesting to see how this success rate is different from what's going on in our format. Next up, we have Dogmatico Monarch with no pantheism. Lund sent me this and he was like, you're going to laugh at this. There's no pantheism in here. There's no point. So this is a deck. So we have one Ecclesia, two copies of Fleur-de-Lis, very standard stuff, triple copies of Aether, one copy of Eldritch the Golden Lord, two copies of Karaz, triple copies of Magician Souls, and then we have the one copy of the Siglaire, the Luminous Lunar Dragon. So you can normal summon or set or this card without tributing, but its original attack becomes 1500. During the main phase, you can target one monster opponent controls with a deck less than or equal to this card. Return this card to the hand. If you do, take control of the opponent's monster until the end of the turn. This is actually kind of cute, and that's on a quick effect, by the way. So I guess we're trying to do some cheesy interaction stuff with this. I guess it works. We have triple copies of Zoborg, aka you want to watch me blow up my extra deck. Then we have one Domain, one copy of Frostblast, triple copies of March, two copies of the Near Servant, and then we have triple copies of Make Two Tokens. These tokens cannot attack and cannot be used with Synchro Material. You cannot summon other monsters turn you activate this, except for light monsters. Light, 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 dark, but that's fine. Light. That's interesting. I guess we got some synergy there. Then we have one Pot of Disparity, triple copies of the Monarchs Erupt. Mr. Golden Lord's bad attack points. Triple copies of Tenacity for searching. Triple Stormforth with one Dogmatic Punishment, one Escalation, and two copies of the Prime Monarch. Extra deck here, we have one Union Carrier, one Tri Brigade Frigate, one Artemis, one Link Spider with one Hippochigan, two copies of the Wind Pegasus, one Omega with one Titan Clad, two copies of the Fossil Warrior, one Five Headed Dragon, and triple copies of Vanitas. Side deck here, we have one Drolan Lockbird, one Erebus, one Majesty Fiend, triple copies of Maxi, one Abira, one Shadal Beast, one Shadal Dragon, with one Construct, one Winda, one Feather Duster, and triple copies of Shadal Fusion. I'm really glad to see that we're just boarding in that entire Shadal package to disrupt the opponent. That's some cheeky stuff right there. So, what do you guys think about these lists? Remember, Black Friday sale tomorrow morning on Market Watch. It'll all start, and it's going to be an interesting ride. I'll see your beautiful faces on the other side. Peace out, guys. Thank you, patrons, for making the ride never truly end. Without you guys' support, well,
I would probably be doing Truffle Shuffle videos for a living. Guys, please check out VanCole40 for all of your Cardfight Vanguard content brought to you by MCole40. And if you are looking to pick up singles, check out MCOLGames.com for your trading card game needs. Thanks for watching, everybody.